Kehlani Sundaran D. Alanese, November 17th. And this is my third intersect athlete support video. This one goes out to Santhi Soundarajan. Sorry, I hope I got that right. That's a tough name. This is the Indian, India, women's silver medalist that was stripped of her medal when it was found out that she had more Y chromosomes than she should have. Intersexed, I believe PAS, and I could be wrong. I'm not sure. Again, partial androgen insensitive syndrome. Basically, she failed the gender test, apparently due to her chromosomes. Born, looked like a girl, was raised a girl, lived her life as a woman, competed as a woman, and unlike Caster Semenya, where she, where Caster Semenya, defeated or ran faster than the other women by a large margin, Santhi Soundarajan won the silver medal and failed the test, gender test, and was disqualified, had her silver medal stripped away. When apparently it was quite obvious to the world, entire world, that she wasn't, astoundingly, faster than other women. She was just as fast. Her best time, apparently, her best run, her highest medal achievement, a silver medal. So for you, Santhi, you're an intersexed athlete, and you should be competing. You should have a lawyer from your country with the backing of your country challenging every athletic committee as well for your right to compete as a woman. You are, in fact, female. You are a woman, regardless of what chromosomes you have. And this goes a warning that goes out to every single parent that has children. At some point in their life, some other person may decide that because of the way they look or what they might have that you're not aware of, that your daughters or sons may not be men or may not be women. And then unlike, here in America where we teach our children that they can do whatever they set their minds to, the real world says, no, you can't. There are stipulations. Well, guess what? Santhi Soundarajan is an intersex woman who was born a girl, grew up as a girl, lived her life as a woman until the so-called failing of the gender test, and had her medal stripped away from her. And regardless of whether or not any other thing else was present, she's still female, still a woman. And it's extremely cold and cruel to actually understand and realize just how bad some people are in our society when they are so judgmental and they don't understand what it means to be a man and what it means to be a woman. It doesn't matter if she has a Y chromosome. She is still female. It doesn't matter if she had higher than normal testosterone levels, which apparently it wasn't an issue. Or her genitalia wasn't female appearing. She had no cosmetic surgery. She was female. She appeared female. And I'm finding amazingly irresponsible of some sporting committee who is so judgmental and bigoted that they would strip a man or woman of the accomplishments they have made. She didn't cheat. She wasn't on drugs, which unfortunately many women and many professional men athletes will do to win. And then two, she didn't win. Well, she won. She won a silver medal. And she has the right to that silver medal. And I believe the world should stand behind you, Santhi Soundarajan. Apologies again if I pronounce that wrong. They should speak up and demand, you know, your silver medal be returned to you, offer in an apology, and if not, the world should boycott all of the, you know, sporting events that's out there, because no group of people has a right to tell, you know, a minority group that you are not equal to other people. You know, God made you this way. You came into the world the way you are. You lived your life as you were, you know, brought up to live. You know, or you came yourself to know and live. And I hope that everyone, regardless of the crude remarks and ridiculous statements, you know, about anatomy or this or that, or, you know, whether you get called a hermaphrodite, technically you would be called a pseudo-hermaphrodite, people need to be educated to understand there's nothing wrong with competing against other women. You're a woman. You know, here in many other countries, they have a medical system that classifies men and women based on conditions. And it doesn't matter what your chromosomes say. You get assigned as a girl or assigned as a boy by parents. Sometimes they're right, sometimes they're wrong. Sometimes, you know, people are cosmetically, surgically corrected to appear more normal as a man or more normal as a woman, and they're still considered men and women. And it doesn't make a damn bit of difference, you know, whether or not you have more wives than expected, you know, and if there are women who you are competing against who are upset that you have won a silver medal, you know, it's like, if they were any better, they would have won the silver or they would have won the gold, you know? So, you know, please, it goes out to you. You're a gifted athlete. Stand up, speak out. And I know I've got a link to a video recording of you somewhere that I have to find again, since this is a different computer. I don't know. I'll put some links to some of the news reports. And I hope you don't mind that I made this video and put it out there in the world. I intend on making another one for Sarah Groner, a tennis player, intersexed, next. Because the world, you know, needs to know that we exist. And we have every right to compete against other people, you know, or, you know, why bother caring about those events at all? If they are so bigoted to put restrictions on who can compete and not compete based on chromosomal variation, you know, and anatomical variation, then the only women who should be competing are women who are 5'3", 110 pounds, have two children biologically, are married. Otherwise, they're not women. Oh, they all must have brunette hair, hazel eyes. How about a snaggle tooth? Okay, that's how ridiculous the gender tests are. You know, putting limitation on who's a man and who's a woman, you know, when we're talking about people who are born as whatever they are, it's a shame that you have experience that you have, the shame, the wrinkle and embarrassment, you know, the rude comments and rude remarks and whatever else that you may experience. Society should know better. You know, the doctor should know better. You know, parents should know better. You know, kids should know better. So they should be taught better. And they're not. And I'm sorry that you have experienced the things you have experienced. I advise you to fight for your right to compete. Don't take, you know, the crap you've taken. You know, fight for that medal. And don't let people go, oh, no, it's, you know, we've already judged you. We've already decided. Go, no. You stand up and you sue. You get a lawyer and you sue. And you go to trial and you fight for that medal. You will have medical experts to stand, you know, so will stand behind you. You will have other athletes stand behind you. And you will win. You know, but you really, really need to make that effort. And I mean, honestly, you need to dig down deep and get all your frustration, anger, and whatever else you can pull out. And you need to challenge your right to compete as a woman because you are a woman. Take care.